Hi, welcome to the setup guide video. First things first, we'll be taking a look at how to set up a Looker Studio template based on the PPC multi-channel example. But if you found yourself in a different template, make sure to scroll through the setup guide sections just to understand what additional things you might need to do, such as change certain metric types once you set up the data source and so on. Without wasting any time, let's get started and click on Setup Couplerio. We'll be prompted to redirect to the flow. So I'm doing this as a completely new user. If you have an account, skip this section, but if you need to create an account with us, you can use the email and password option. Just confirm it and then come back here. For this example, I will be using the sign in with Google option. Just using my email, making sure I click continue. And now that I am signed in, I'm automatically put on a free trial and I will be prompted to connect my credentials. So let's start with the Facebook ads and LinkedIn ads, just to keep it simple. Please note, when you connect your source credentials for the first time, you'll have to authorize the Couplerio app with those tools such as Facebook ads. So by clicking on connect, it will prompt you to create new credentials and connect to Facebook. Just click start here and make sure to log into Facebook and follow through with the rest of the process. I'll skip it over. So let's go back to setting up the data flow. All right, so now that we've done that, we will see something like this, where I'll be able to select the source account and then select the ad account. You can select one or multiple ones. I'll just do one for the sake of the video. And then let's also plug in LinkedIn ads in a very similar way. Select the ad account. Next, we're going to connect the data that Couplerio prepares to the Looker Studio data source. Let's click connect. After that, we'll click generate data source. So if you're doing it for the first time, you will have an authorization with Looker Studio procedure. So just select your country, type in your company, click continue. Just say yes to all to not worry about it, and then click continue. Cancel this, and let's now authorize the Couplerio data connector. This is a one-time action when you're doing this for the first time, and then once you are done with this, let's connect Looker Studio to your Couplerio account. And then now that we can close this tab, let's close it. And then over here, you'll see that the workflow is going to be synchronized with the Looker Studio data source. Before we proceed, let's make sure that the email account we're using to connect to Looker Studio is the same that we have in our Couplerio account. And then, important to note that you want to keep this checkbox with the use report templates for new reports enabled before you click connect. While we're here, please note that it's a very good practice to give this a definitive name. So something like a PPC multi-channel report, in our case, Facebook plus LinkedIn, whatever makes sense to you, because if you don't rename it, it's all going to be untitled and easy to navigate in Looker Studio later. So once you do that, click on connect, and it's going to force the execution of the Couplerio workflow. I'll pause the video, and then when it happens, we'll come back to it. So now that the data source is generated, we can look through some of these metrics, and what you can do is maybe change your amount spent to a currency that you have in your account. Metrics such as CPC, CPM, and CTR can also use an adjustment in the format. So let's make these currencies, and then CPM currency as well. And then for CTR, we can do percent. Okay, so now we can click on create report. Sometimes Google wants us to say yes to everything once again. Let's click yes, and then we can continue with the previous action. If you guys run into this loop, so what usually helps is refreshing the page and then clicking on create report again. Okay. So now that we can create the report, we'll click on the create report button, let the Looker Studio load. All right, and now that we have the data source here, the template is going to be rendered. You can see that everything is populated into it automatically. And you are also landed in the edit mode, so you can make certain changes, such as change branding, design, maybe add a couple of widgets based on all the data that you have in this data flow over here. Going back to the setup guide over here, please note that this template by default only has data for last 2 months, as well as it only has data points for the widgets that are included by default to be rendered automatically. So if you're looking to add certain things, like let's say maybe conversions or some metrics related to that, we will have a totally separate video on how to approach customizing these templates and how to do it pretty quickly and easily. If you have any questions or ran into any challenges during the setup process, don't hesitate to book a call with our team and go through the dashboard setup together. So stay tuned, and that's it for this video.